वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ बी के सिंह, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम ओरिएंटल पब्लिक स्कूल किशनगंज। स्टूडेंट्स, ड्यूरिंग लास्ट वीडियो वी हैड डिस्कस्ड कोरोजन, रैंसिडिटी एंड द डिफरेंट कंपोजिशन ऑफ रस्ट। ऑल्सो वी हैड डिस्कस्ड द कंडीशन विच हेल्प एंड प्रोमोट रस्टिंग एंड स्टूडेंट we have also discussed the prevention of rusting, that means how can we prevent an iron from rust. Now in today's video student, we'll discuss why does the exposed surface of a cut brinjal become black. So first of all student, you know ki brinjal is a type of vegetable which comes in the group of other vegetables, and these vegetables have very low percentage of fat but have more vitamins and minerals, and also have a special type of pigments like anthocyanin. And friends, anthocyanin provides a scarlet purple color to brinjals and is a type of glucoside. And brinjals also have tannin which are colorless. Students, when brinjals are cut, their exposed surface changes to black color, and this blackening of cut surface is caused by a reaction between the tannin in the brinjal and air. That means during this reaction the tannin get oxidized and hence its color become black. After this student, we'll discuss why do exposed surface of cut apple and bananas become brownies. So student, here you can see okay, the brownish of cut surface of apple is caused by a reaction between enzymes in the fruits and the air. Vitamin C delays this reaction, and fruits with large amount of vitamin C take longer time to turn brown. And there is another reason for browning of cut surface of apple is that apple also has iron in ferrous state. In the presence of air, the ferrous iron is converted into ferric iron, which is brown in color. And if we compare the rate of browning or blackening, so we find that the time taken in each one to turn brown, the apple will probably start to turn brown first, then comes banana, and lastly citrus fruit. That means citrus, and we can say citrus fruit does not turn brown because it has excessive vitamin C. And after this student, we will discuss that why is sea water salty. Although we had discussed about this topic in last video, but let's see one thing, that is why we can understand this one by this way, that suppose this is the land part and this is sea region, sea area. So student, you know ki during daytime when sun is bright, its sun ray falls on the water, and this sun ray causes warming of this water, and because of more temperature, rise in temperature, the water starts evaporating, and this vapor strength rises up and forms cloud. It forms cloud, and this cloud strength further moves toward the land. And in land, students, suppose it is a land part. So in land part, what happens? In land part, students, you might have seen that is here more plants are there, and some part where there is forest. Because of forest, here the temperature is little less. And students, because of less temperature, you know, the vapors which are the gaseous form of water, being low getting low temperature, it start raining. And in during raining, what happens? The raindrops fall on the ground, and this ground strength, actually on the grounds, many minerals and salts are present. And salts, strength, you know, it is soluble in water. So these minerals and salts get dissolved in, and as water runs through various regions, it collects all these salts with it, and it carry to the sea. And strength, this process remains continue for years, and this collect all the salt to the sea, but leaving the salt, it again evaporates and forms cloud and rains. Again, this rainwater dissolve the salt in it and carry to the sea. Again, leaving sea, yearly salt, sea water again move further and forming cloud, and again it rains. This goes on circulating. This is also known as water cycle. So this water cycle, because of water cycle, strength, everywhere it carries different type of salt to the sea, and thus salt water, sea water become salty. And after this, strength, we'll discuss the solutions are of we can categorize all the solutions into three types. These are saturated solution, unsaturated solution, and super saturated solution. So students, saturated, to understand saturated, unsaturated, first of all, you think about the container. Suppose we will take a container like a beaker, and in this beaker, we'll put some water, and it is like this. So in this beaker, we have put some water. Now strength, we'll take some amount of salt and one spoon. With the help of a spoon, we'll put some salt in this container. So in this container, when we'll put some salt, strength, so in that case, what will happen? We'll find that suppose we have put half a spoonful of salt in one beaker of water. In that one, after putting, we'll stir it. After stirring, we'll find it has got dissolved. Now student will take some more amount of salt. So in this situation, in this solution, we know that if we have mix up only half a spoonful of salt in this solution, it can dissolve more salt. The salt in this case is solute. So this solution actually, student, is unsaturated solution. So unsaturated solution, that means the solution in which more solute can be dissolved is called unsaturated solution. Now students, next, in this one further, in this beaker further, here already we have mixed some amount of salt in it, and again we are going on mixing more and more salt in it. So what will happen? Definitely a time will come when it will stop dissolving more salt. So the solution, when it will stop dissolving more solution, at this situation we can say the solution is saturated. And how we can define it in this way: if the solution in which no more solute can be dissolved is called saturated solution. And now student, we'll discuss super saturated solution. So students, you know,
कि इफ वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन, दिस इज सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन, वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन, वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन एंड इन दिस सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन वी कैन नॉट डिजॉल्व मोर वाटर, बट स्ट्रीन इफ यू विल हीट इट, इफ विल हीट इट, सपोज हियर विल यूजिंग द सोर्स ऑफ हीट, इफ विल हीट दिस सॉल्यूशन, आफ्टर हीटिंग इट मोर सॉल्यूट कैन बी डिजॉल्व, इट विल, दैट मीन्स इट विल बिकम अनसेचुरेटेड. तो आफ्टर हीटिंग इट डिजॉल्विंग मोर सॉल्ट इन इट अगेन. नाउ कूल दिस हॉट सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन इन अ फ्रिज फॉर सम टाइम टिल द सॉल्यूशन गेट्स सुपर कूल एंड स्वेंट. नाउ एड अ लिटिल मोर ऑफ सॉल्ट टू इट, द सॉल्यूशन कैन नाउ डिजॉल्व मोर सॉल्ट. सच सॉल्यूशन इज टर्म्ड एज अ सुपर सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन. दस सुपर सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन is a solution that contain more solute and there is a equilibrium between the dissolved solute and undissolved solute. And after this student we'll discuss some application of super saturated solution, and in that super saturated solution we'll discuss first we'll discuss separation of substances by crystallization. And first of all we should understand what is crystal. So see students, it is a homogeneous solid body which is formed when a certain liquid substance passes into solid state, and most of the compound possess a definite crystal form in the solid condition are said to be crystalline, and solid body is known as crystal. And one more thing, what is crystallization? What is crystallization? We'll understand this. What is crystallization? So crystallization, actually the process to get pure solid crystals from impure solution is called crystallization. Actually this is a process to get pure solid crystal from impure solutions, it is carried out in the four steps, that is preparation of saturated solution of impure compound in a suitable solvent, filter the above solution to remove insoluble impurities, now cool it to get crystal of solid. These crystals of pure solid are filtered and dried. Now students will discuss fractional crystallization. Actually it is a process of separation of a crystalline substance from a mixture, and this type of crystallization is used for the mixture of two or more compounds which are soluble in the same solvent but at different degree. The hot saturated solution of the mixture is allowed to cool when the less soluble compounds crystallizes out before the more soluble compound. Now we'll discuss how is crystallization carried out. So the process of crystallization is carried out in the few following steps here. Number one is choice of solvent. This means the solvent which dissolves a solid compound on heating and throws out maximum crystals on cooling is said to be a good choice of the solvent. Second is preparation of solution. So a suitable quantity of solid substance is taken in conical flask and fitted with a reflux condenser. The quantity of solvent should be just enough to dissolve the whole solid on boiling. The heating should be carried on water bath or wire gauge if the solvent is volatile. After that strength, there is filtration of the solution. The filtration of solution, the hot saturated solution obtained above is then filtered through filter paper placed in an ordinary glass funnel. If the solution is large, it takes longer time and some crystals may appear in funnel during filtration. to prevent it, hot water funnel may be used in this process. And after that, crystallization is there. So crystallization. Lastly, crystallization is there. The hot filtrate is then allowed to cool undisturbed in a beaker or a crystalline dish. The crystals of pure substances separates out. And finally, separation and drying of crystals are done. The crystals are separated from the mother liquor by filtration, and these crystals are dried in vacuum desiccator. Okay, students, thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day and stay home, stay safe.